फ्रॉम एलपी सवाणी रिवरसाइड स्कूल कृपाली हूँ। चैप्टर नंबर 3 फाइबर टू फैब्रिक। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज सिल्क। हाउ वी आर ऑप्टिंग सिल्क एंड हाउ इट इज प्रोसीड टू कन्वर्ट इनटू द फैब्रिक वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टुडे। सिल्क 3.2। सिल्क फाइबर्स आर ऑल्सो एनिमल फाइबर्स बिकॉज इट इज ऑप्टेंड फ्रॉम द सिल्क वर्म्स। सिल्क वर्म्स स्पाइंस द सिल्क फाइबर्स मीन्स दे प्रोड्यूस द सिल्क फाइबर। द रियरिंग ऑफ सिल्क वर्म्स फॉर ऑप्टेनिंग द सिल्क इज कॉल्ड सेरिकल्चर। सेरिकल्चर मीन्स रियरिंग ऑफ द सिल्क वर्म एंड आवर पर्पज इज ऑप्टेनिंग द सिल्क। रियरिंग मीन्स टू ग्रोविंग द सिल्क वर्म बाय प्रोवाइडिंग दैम शेल्टर फीडिंग एंड फूड विथ अ प्रॉपर ब्रीडिंग फैसिलिटी। फाइंड आउट फ्रॉम योर मदर आंट और ग्रैंड मदर द काइंड ऑफ सिल्क साड़ीज दे हैव। लिस्ट द काइंड ऑफ सिल्क इट मीन्स यू आर इजिली एबल टू सी द सिल्क साड़ीज ऑफ द लेडीज। बिफोर वी डिस्कस द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑब्टेनिंग सिल्क इट इज नेसेसरी टू नो द इंटरेस्टिंग लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ द सिल्क मौत। देर आर इंटरेस्टिंग लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ द सिल्क वर्म्स और ऑफ द सिल्क मौत। लेट्स सी लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ द सिल्क मौत हाउ दे आर गेटिंग एल्डर। द फीमेल सिल्क मौत लेज एग फ्रॉम विच हैच लार्वे विच आर कोल्ड कैटरपिलर्स और सिल्क वर्म्स। फीमेल मौत इट मीन्स फीमेल मौत विल बी लेज eggs and caterpillar will be produced or you can say silkworms. They grow in size and when the caterpillar is ready to enter the next stage of his life history called pupa, the caterpillar will able to enter into the next stage of the life. It is called pupa. Its first weaves a net to hold itself. Then it swings its head from side to side in the form of the figure of eight. During this movement of the head, the caterpillar secretes fiber made of a protein which hardens on exposure to air and becomes silk fibers. Means this moth will be secretes the protein fiber with the hardness of atmosphere. They will become silk fiber. Soon the caterpillar completely covers itself by silk fibers and turns into the pupa. They will again turns into the pupa. This covering is known as cocoon. The further development of the pupa into moth continues inside the cocoon. Silk fibers are used for weaving silk cloth. Can you imagine that the soft silk yarn is as strong as comparable thread of steel? It means it is also very strengthable material, very strengthful fabric. The silk yarn thread is obtained from the cocoon of the silk moth. There is a variety of silk moths which looks very different from one another, and the silk yarn they yield is different in texture. In texture means they are smooth or rough, shiny or dull and coarse, etc. These are their properties of texture. Texture you can say that in the appearance. Thus tussar silk, Muga silk, Kosa silk, etc. are obtained from cocoon spun by different types of moths. The most common silk moth is mulberry silk moth. The silk fiber from the cocoon of silk moth is soft, lustrous and elastic and can be dyed in beautiful color. We can convert it into the different shades of the colors. Sericulture or culture of silkworms is a very old occupation in India. India produces plenty of silk on a commercial scale. India is produced very large amount of silk on the commercial stages. Next activity, collect pieces of silk cloth of various type and paste them in your scrapbook. You have to take sample of the different variety of the silk. You can find them in a tailor shop among the heap of waste cut paste. And from that shop, you can study the different variety of these silks. Take help of your mother, aunt or teacher and identify the types of silk such as mulberry silk, tassar silk, airy silk, muga silk, etc. Compare the texture of the silks with that of the artificial silk pieces. Silk is also available artificially, which contains synthetic fibers. Try and collect picture of different moths whose caterpillars provide the various types of silks. Synthetic fibers means produce the fibers man-made, artificial fibers. They are not occurs naturally. Activity number 3.6. Take an artificial silk thread and pure silk thread. Burn these threads carefully. Did you notice any difference in smell while burning? Now burn a woolen fiber carefully. Did it smell like burning of artificial silk or that pure silk? Can you explain why? To remember when the cocoon stages is reached in the life history of the silk moth, try the following activity. It means when you will burn the artificial and natural silk thread, then the both of the burning will give you the different kind of the smell, and one of them smell will be similar to the burning of the woolen thread. Photocopy in the figure 3.9, cut out pictures of the stages of life history of the silk moth and paste them on a piece of the cardboard or chart paper to collect the data. Jumble them, now trying and arrange the stages in the correct sequence in a cyclic form. Whoever does it fastest wins. It is the one activity for your fun and the improving the knowledge. You may also describe the life history in your own words. Write it down in your scrapbook. Life history you can found here in your textbook. First one, this one is the male moth. This one is the female. Adult silk moths is, these are the adult silk moth, means very mature stages. This one is the silkworm and egg on mulberry leaves. These all are egg, you can see here in a dot form. Cocoon is here shown in the figure number E, and cocoon with developing moth is the here. This all is life history of the silk moth. From cocoon to silk. For obtaining silk, moths are reared and their cocoons are collected to get silk threads. Rearing silkworms. How rearing of silkworm is occur? A female silk moth lays hundreds of eggs at a time. At a time, they are able to lay hundreds of the eggs. The eggs are stored carefully on strip of cloth or paper and sold to silkworm farmers. It means eggs are sold to the farmers. The farmer keeps eggs under hygienic condition, means very sterile condition, and under suitable condition of temperature and humidity at their favorable condition of the environment. The eggs are warmed to suitable temperature for the larva to hatch from eggs. This is done when mulberry trees bear a fresh crop of leaves. These are the mulberry trees. What is happen here? Eggs forever are sold to the farmers, are warmed to a suitable temperature for the larva to hatch from the eggs. It means to output, to get the silkworms from that particular egg, we have to warm that. We have to provide them a temperature period for their warming. This is done when mulberry trees bear a fresh crop of leaves. The larva, called caterpillars or silkworm, eat day and night and increase enormously in the size. They will increase in the size. Here you can see that female silkworm moth with the eggs. These eggs will be collected and on the mulberry tree they are transferring in the particular temperature period. Here you can see larva or caterpillar or silkworm feeding on the mulberry leaves. They will get nutrition from this leaf and will increase in the size and growth will occur. And it is the cocoons which is our purpose of this rearing of silkworms. The larvae are kept in clean bamboo trays along with a freshly chopped mulberry leaves. After 25 to 30 days, the caterpillar stops eating and moves to a tiny chamber of bamboo in the tray to spin cocoons. Means this cocoon will form after 25 to 30 days. Small rags or twigs may be provided in the trays to which cocoons get attached. The caterpillar or silkworm spin to cocoon inside which develops the silk moth. Processing of silk. How the processing will occur by obtaining, by collecting this silk? Let's see. A pile of cocoon is used for obtaining silk fibers. The cocoons are kept under the sun or boiled or exposed to steam. Means we have to provide heat the cocoons by direct contact with sun or by boiling or by steam providing. The silk fibers separated out. The process of taking out threads from the cocoon for use as a silk is called reeling the silk. Reeling the silk means separate the silk from the cocoon. Pehli wants to know if the cotton thread and silk thread are spun and woven in the same manner. Let's see. Reeling is done in a special machines which unwind the threads or fibers of silk from the cocoons. There are very kind of special machines for formation of the reeling. Silk fibers are then spun into the silk threads which are woven into silk cloth by weavers. This is the cycle of the silk. Such a way silk we are obtained from silk fiber to the silk fabric. Here your chapter number 3 is over.